Here's how you make a primitive hunting arrow. Right here I have a dogwood shaft. I cut it, scrape the bark off, and start straightening it as it dries. Within a week, it's totally dry, or you can force dry it by the fire. Here I have a bag of stone flakes. This is a Waihi Jasper. This is my preferred material. I really like to use totally primitive tools, just so that I have that skill. Little spots in the flake like this are great for scraping arrow shafts. You can see those curls that are so easily taken off by this. It's really not all that less efficient than a steel knife. This was the top end of that shoot growing out of the ground. And here's the bottom end. When it tapers like that, you want the thick end to be in the front because that holds the punching power of the arrow. Now the sort of arrows I make are called Eastern Woodland 2 Fletch, or sometimes a Cherokee 2 Fletch. So here's fletching. You can see it's just a feather, and I just grabbed about halfway down and peeled it. This is a turkey feather fletching, and this always works best with turkey feathers. You can use a razor sharp stone flake to trim down those feathers. That's the pattern you want it cut in, and we leave this little bit on top to tie it down with the sinew. Now I just need to cut it a little shorter. About like that should work. This is deer leg sinew. I'll show how to make that in another video. Strip it into pieces and chew it. It's not as gross as you think. Just get the wrap started and get your fletchings in there. Then you just tuck the little tail of that sinew underneath that last wrap and it will dry super secure. Here's how the nock is carved on that arrow. I'm gonna make a small saw out of this stone flake here to carve that nock. I use pieces of antler to shape this stone. It's called flint knapping. There's that saw. There we go. Now we'll carve a notch for that arrow point. There we go. Nice little point. Primitive glue made from pine sap, charcoal, and animal fat. Don't lose your arrowhead, like I almost did. Heat up this pitch glue, and I applied some onto that arrowhead, and then just crammed it in there. Applying a little bit of heat after it's set is good to do. There we go. And you do the wrap like this. Go around the base, keep everything tight. That is a finished arrow.